Hello, hello. We're good to go.
Front porch show.
Hello, hello. We're good to go on with the front porch show.
It's a Christmas show.
Front porch show.
Let it be cold.
Front porch show.
Let it be cold. We're set to go on with the front porch show. We'll have a
ho, ho. It's the Front Porch Show Christmas Special!
Hello!
Starring John Stevens! I am Tom Van Gannon, along with the piano man Frank St. Germain! Please welcome John and his guests, Paul and Kayla Drew!
Whoa.
Community Calendar with Lauren Eady! The Anglican Church Choir! The Habermills.
Whoa.
And yours truly in Victoria Kaidoff. All tonight on the Front Porch Christmas Special.
Now we'll have a ho ho or two.
Ho ho ho.
Big ho ho's for me and you.
Here we go. Hello, hello.
Front Porch Show.
We're set to go. Christmas show.
Here he is, John Stevens.
I got a microphone.
Excellent.
I got a headset microphone. I guess you're a star when you have it. Well, welcome to the Front Porch Show Christmas Special. And whether you believe in a supreme being, karma, or just plain good luck, isn't it grand weather we're having on this wonderful December night? It's the Front Porch Show. We never get rained on, and in December we have, again, 4-degree weather. It's incredible. The cast and crew have been busy as Santa's elves getting ready for this one. We hope you really enjoy it. There are a few people we have to think that have been quite helpful in putting this show together. First and foremost have been our show sponsors, the staff and family, and the St. Mary's Golf and Country Club. The St. Mary's Independent, as usual, has been great. We're talking about the newspaper. And the St. Mary's Independent Grocery Store has helped out as well. We'd like to thank the hot chocolate and coffee has been generously supplied by baristas. Let's hear it for the hot chocolate. And we appreciate Fawcett Tractor Supply, the Flower Shop and more, the St. Mary's ANAF, and all the others who had the we can do this attitude for the letters for our troops. And of course, it's a given that this show wouldn't happen without the talent, both on and off the camera, that people donate. We do it all for the love of this town, and I guess that's why you show up too, on a cool night. So let's have a cool time here. We live in an awesome place. But before we go on, who's come from the farthest place? How many, who's come from Stratford? Put up your hands, shout it out. Nobody, okay. Must be something going on in Stratford, right?
What else
could
be going on Sunday night in Stratford?
Yeah, not in December. The festival's not on. Anyways, okay, anybody here from Toronto?
Hardy, yep.
Who's from St. Mary's?
Yay!
Is there anybody else farther from St. Mary's?
Woodstock!
Woodstock, okay. Where, oh, we have somebody from where?
North Pole!
Woo-hoo! Okay, we have some other people. Where are they from? I know we have some people from out of the country.
Turkey!
Istanbul, Turkey! So for all our Turkish fans, there we go. Where's that? Paris, France. Let's hear it for Paris, France. Folks, we are going international. Okay. Well,
Before we go, look who we have here. Where's Andrea? Where are you, Andrea? It's in dark. You can't see beyond the lights here. Okay, we need a microphone. Don, I need your microphone. Okay. Andrea, tell me about the winter lights that are going on.
Oh, the winter lights are going on. They were lit on November 15th after the Santa Claus parade, and they are continuing until Sunday, January 5th, I believe. Lit nightly from 5 o'clock till 11 o'clock.
Okay, fantastic.
What else can I tell you about?
Well, you can tell me about the wagon ride.
I absolutely can. This coming weekend, the 14th, the 15th, and then the 21st, the 22nd, and the 24th are the horse-drawn wagon rides around the light display from 6:30 till 8:30 p.m. As always, viewing the lights and going on the wagon rides is free. However, your donations are greatly appreciated. Testing the lights, building the display, and then dismantling them at the end of the season is a costly venture, but a beloved one. So when you see Waving Santa or some of the other donation boxes, if you could help offset that cost, it'll keep our taxes down.
Hey! And when is the last day for them?
Sorry. I may not have a job after this. The last day
you
is...
You can come and be the host of the Front Porch Show.
Oh,
I may not have a job after this either.
Yeah, all of us.
The last day is Sunday, January 5th of 2020. So that first Sunday of the new year is the last day for the winter lights.
Okay, fine. Thanks for coming in.
You're welcome.
And we'll see you around.
Yes, Merry Christmas.
Okay, Merry Christmas. Okay, we're supposed to be out front. We're supposed to be in front of the frame. There we go. Out in the light. Out into the light. Not in the dark. There we go. In the light. There we go. Thank you very much. Okay. We're now going to go over to Charlotte. Tell us who you have with you, Charlotte.
I have Georgia. And how old are you, Georgia?
9.
Okay. What's your favorite?
What do you have again, Charlotte? We didn't quite hear that.
Okay, hi Georgia. How old are you?
9.
Okay, what's your favorite part of Christmas?
Christmas trees.
Okay, let's hear it for the Christmas tree.
Christmas tree right over here, John.
Okay, fantastic. Okay. Now, we're next going to go. The Droogs are one of the great musical families in St. Mary's. And you have Paul and Kayla playing one of Paul's original compositions, The Greatest Gift.
Oh, I thought Paul. Oh, sorry.
Well, thank you, John. Thanks, everybody. It's a pleasure to sit down with Kayla and play. Kayla sat down and played this song for the first time in the studio, actually, this summer. And we recorded this song called The Greatest Gift. When I was young, full of dreams, Christmas Day held such joy. I was always wondering if all my wishing had brought that special toy. And I remember all the bright gifts open on Christmas morn. But I knew they weren't as wonderful as the gift of a child being born. The greatest gift ever given was on that first Christmas day. Showed the greatest love ever shown. Such a special way
When among all the people God sent his son, a tiny beautiful gift meant for everyone. His gift was bright enough, or if it was too big or small, he gave though we had no gift for him. The kind of love is the greatest gift of all. Christmas Day, show the greatest love ever shown. Such a special way. When among all the people God sent his son, tiny beautiful gift meant for everyone.
Kayla, very good.
Wow.
Okay, the Christmas season is certainly bustling in St. Mary's, and here to tell you about it is the famous columnist, the one and only from the St. Mary's Independent, Lauren Eady, in her poop onesie. Wow, that looks really Christmassy.
My poop onesie.
Oh, yeah.
Get this right side up. Hello, hello. So, there's a lot going on this December. Tomorrow, the St. Mary's Community Players are hosting auditions for Trying, a play by Joanna McClellan Glass. They're from 7 to 9 p.m. at the Presbyterian Church. There's also trivia at Gordy's, and this is beginning at 7 p.m. every Monday night, and all are welcome. On Thursday, December 12th, there will be a live broadcast of the Lincolns game at Sarnia, and if you'd like to listen to it, you can go to stmarysradio.com to listen in. On Friday, Jenny's is also hosting their fourth annual Christmas dinner for two. Seatings are at 11 a.m. and 1 p.m., $15.95 per person, and call for reservations. On Friday is also the Army and Navy weekly meat draw, and it's starting at 6 p.m. And the Lincolns will be playing, and they have a home game, and it's against London at the PRC.
Woo!
So everyone come out.
All right.
And show them who's boss. Saturday, December 14th is the Royal Canadian Legion's meat draw, which starts at 5 p.m. Visit the winter lights at the Milt Tunnel Field, which has been lit since the Santa Claus Parade and has over 100 attractions, which you can view by car or foot. And they also have horse-drawn wagon rides, which are being offered to view the lights starting December 14th and continuing the 15th, 21st, 22nd, and 24th from 6:30 to 8:30 in the evening. First come, first serve. Sponsored skating at the PRC begins on the 14th and continues until January 11th. The first event being held is sponsored by the River Road Run. December the 20th, there is another Lincoln's Home game, again against London.
Yeah.
At the PRC, so everyone come out. And the next big news on the agenda is December 21st, where the Independent has received some tips that Santa Claus is coming to town.
So I hear.
Yeah, apparently. So this event is happening after bedtime. But please stay tuned for the following morning on December 25th, where there should be some further developments. There will also be a family New Year's Eve party at the PRC on December 31st from 6 to 8 p.m. with swimming, skating, and a ball drop. The Army and Navy will also be hosting a New Year's Eve potluck. All are welcome. And for more information, please visit stmarysindy.com or thetownofstmarys.com. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year, everyone.
Okay. The musical scene in St. Mary's, as you know, is very, very rich and growing all the time. One of the traditions here is church choirs. And representing our good Anglicans, let's hear it for the Anglicans. Oh, come on, the Anglicans are better. Now let's hear it for the Anglicans. There we go. Is this group singing Mary's Boy Child. Church to go through that has a great choir, go to the Anglican Church. Way to go. Thank you for coming. Okay, our good friend Will has somebody who wants to talk to us. Will!
Hi, I've got Bree with me here. And how old are you, Bree?
9.
Bree, have you been naughty or nice this year?
Nice.
Well, I might have to check with your parents about that one, but here you go, I guess. Merry Christmas, Bree.
Okay, thank you, Will. Great. By the way, behind Will, you're going to see a picture frame here. If some of you have friends and relatives, like in Paris, France, or Istanbul, that you want to stand in the frame and give a shout out and say hello to your friends and family, please do that, because this show, while it's live now, it is on the internet. We'll be putting it on YouTube and our Facebook group. So please do that, okay? Okay, there we go. So now, Christmas is a time of giving, and we have some award-winning actors here. Let's hear it for our award-winning actors. To present the St. Mary's premiere of The Gift.
It's a gift for my friend.
Fantastic.
Incredible.
And unbelievably true.
What's that?
It's a gift for my friend.
Fantastic. Incredible. And unbelievably
true.
That gift would look much better in a box.
That's a great idea!
What's that?
It's a box!
Oh, dear.
And a gift for my friend!
Fantastic!
Incredible! Unbelievably true!
But that box would look so much better with wrapping paper, ribbon, and a bow.
Great idea.
What's that? It's wrapping paper, ribbons, and a bow.
And a box.
And a gift for my friend.
Fantastic.
Incredible.
And unbelievably true. But that wrapping paper, ribbons, and bow would look much better with a card. For the wrapping paper, ribbons, and bow.
Great idea.
For a gift for my friend. Fantastic! Incredible! Unbelievably true!
What's that?
It's a card.
To put on the wrapping paper, the ribbons, and the bow.
To put on the box.
For a gift for my friend.
Fantastic! Incredible! And unbelievably true!
But that card would be better with a bow.
That's a great idea!
What's that?
It's a bowl.
For the card.
For the wrapping paper, ribbon, and bowl.
For the box.
For a gift for my friend.
Fantastic!
Incredible! And unbelievably true!
But
what's that?
I'm not done.
That poem would be much better if it was a song written by Elton John and sung by Celine Dion.
Great idea.
What's that?
Oh, that's me.
It's a song written by Elton John and sung by Celine Dion.
From a poem.
For the card.
On the wrapping paper, bow, and ribbon.
For a box.
For a gift for my friend.
Fantastic!
Incredible! And unbelievably true!
But that song would be better if it were in a Disney movie!
Great idea!
What's that?
It's a Disney movie!
From a poem.
With a song written by Elton John and sung by Celine Dion.
From a poem.
From a card. For the ribbon, bows, and wrapping paper.
For a box.
For a gift for my friend.
Fantastic! Incredible! Unbelievably true!
But that Disney movie would be so much better if it was in parts 2, 3, 4, and 5.
Great idea!
Let's do it!
Hey, they forgot the gift. Anyone want a gift?
Okay, there we go. Let's hear for our players for this play called The Gift. Okay. Another of our musical family is the Hammermills. And here to entertain us are Stephen Hammermill. How do I say that?
You got hamburger on your mind, man.
Hammermill. There we go. Have I got it right?
Sure.
And his sister Lee Pickle with a special number for you.
Oh, sound people.
Well, they billed us as the Hammermill family, but we've kind of shrunk.
Yeah.
Well, we've gotten big enough.
Yeah, I haven't shrunk.
Yeah.
I've lost 100 pounds about 5 times.
Yeah, it keeps coming back, right?
Yeah.
Ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. A newborn king to see. Ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. Our finest gifts we bring. Ba-rum-ba-bum-bum. Rum-ba-bum-bum. Rum-ba-bum-bum. He's on top. Ba-rum-ba-bum-bum.
Can it be?
Years from now, perhaps we'll see. Our finest gifts will bring glory. To see the day
when men of goodwill live in peace, live in peace again.
So
peace on earth. Can it be?
Every child must be made aware. Every child must be made to care. Care enough for his fellow man to give all the love that he
incredible and unbelievably true. Thank you very much.
but. There's no buts about it. There's no buts about it. Okay, we have Will over here again, and he has, who's this little kid he has? Will?
This is Peter.
And how old is he?
I'm 8.
What grade are you in?
4.
Have you been nice this year?
I've been incredibly nice.
All right.
Oh!
Here you go.
Thank you very much, Will.
Have a Merry Christmas.
And same to you.
Be nice to your parents.
I will. She's 95 and she drives a red sports car. Can you believe that?
Yeah.
Everything else has been a lie, but that's the truth. She's 95 and she still drives a red 2015 Ford Focus.
Okay. Oh, yes. Okay. Done.
Actually, I believe when he says he's in grade 4. I've watched his behavior level. Okay. It's right about there.
We're not ready
it's
for you
the 8
yet,
stuff. I know that. Oh, I'm just helping you out here.
Okay, well, you know something? I usually need a lot of help.
Yeah, exactly.
So thank you. What do we have here? Oh, although Giving Tuesday has come and gone. You know what's the hard part about this? We usually do this show in the summer. And in the summer, people aren't all dressed up like this. So I'm having trouble seeing where people are, and I really can't see beyond the lights. So I have no idea where people are. But out there somewhere is Cindy Taylor. Oh, there she is. So Giving Tuesday has come and gone, and the Front Porch Show has extended today because we're doing some Giving Tuesday. We're giving to the Salvation Army and our troops. And one of the organizers about this event is Cindy Taylor. Cindy, come on over. Oh, you are over here.
I'm here, yes. I am.
And tell us about how we did in St. Mary's.
John, have you been drinking?
I haven't. I'm really thirsty, in fact.
We have an honorary giving
for you. Fantastic. Let's try it on.
So Giving Tuesday started in 2012 in the U.S. Oh, nice.
How do you know it's for your head, John?
Started in 2012 in the U.S., and it was basically a movement that sort of wanted to take away from the craziness of Black Friday and Cyber Monday. So they came up with Giving Tuesday, which was all about how to give back to your community. So St. Mary's joined the movement 2 years ago, and we had 18 partners. Last year we had 42, and this year we had 70.
Okay, now tell me how that stacks up. Yeah, 70 people, that's wonderful. Tell me how that stacks up with some other communities in, we don't want to embarrass them, but what do we do?
Well, what's amazing about it is the size of St. Mary's compared to, I'll use Windsor as an example. My husband's from Windsor, so I'll use Windsor. They actually had, I think, 17, and St. Mary's had 70. And actually, out of the entire country, there's actually 41 civic movements, and St. Mary's is one of them. But we actually have the most, 48 partners that are actually businesses. There's not another civic movement across the country that as many businesses joined.
Yes.
And what we accomplished was just mind-boggling. From donations, from, you know, people participating, like for instance, baristas donated, I think they ended up being $1,500 for families. Zenfire Pottery sold small little pottery hearts for mental health. They sold 175. They raised over $1,000. It was the schools were involved, the Little Falls, Holy Name, and DCVI. Incredible food drives were done. It really was an unbelievable day.
And the Front Porch Show has been part of it as well.
And well, what's amazing too is we were actually the first community to raise the Giving Tuesday flag. I don't know if any of you noticed, but it's right beside the Canada flag. And we actually have the flag here that we had almost all the partners signed. So the Front Porch Show has not signed yet. So they can...
Whoops.
So again, my husband went around and got almost every partner to sign the Giving Tuesday flag. And again, it shows what an incredible community we live in. It really was unbelievable.
And who's good at writing? I am terrible at writing. Is anybody a good writer? Come on over here. Cher, yeah, Cher's our wonderful professional writer. There we go. She's going to sign it.
She's
going to put it on
right
his table.
First time, every time.
Yeah. She's got her own black market. She's made for this. Okay, maybe we can use this table here, Don. And while they're signing it, let me tell you what we're doing. At the end of the show, one, you brought gifts for the Salvation Army, and look at that. Wow, quite a few. We have our letters for the troops. We're going to talk about that later. And we have Front Porch Show mugs available at the end of the show. We're selling them. We usually sell them for what you can give, but for tonight, we want you to give $10 per mug to the Salvation Army, so we're selling them for $20, and $10 of that will go to the Salvation Army. We also got the kettle over here, and if you want to drop a bit of money in the kettle, please do, because the Salvation Army does great work in our community. Yep. Okay, look at this. Can you zoom in on this, Fern? Yep. So we can see the Front Porch Show. There we go.
John, we also have for you, for the staff, I guess. These were incredible decorated boxes from Little Falls students and Holy Name students. There's cookies in there for you.
Okay.
They colored 250 boxes, and then we actually sold them in our bakery, and we actually raised over $2,000 for Vaughn, for Perth Huron.
Cindy, I don't think I'm going to see those cookies. They're going to probably disappear before the end of the show. But anyways, the thought is what happened this Christmas. Thank you for coming in, Cindy.
Well, thank you.
Okay, then we can get rid of this, take this off. Thank you. Okay, you're now, how do you like the show so far? I think this is our best Christmas show yet. I'm having fun. It's a bit of a zoo at times, but that's the Front Porch Show because we're by the seat of our pants productions. We now have a special treat. Where is it? Oh, there he is. Dawn Van Galen is brought to the Front Porch Show. A distinguished guest. Dawn, tell us about her.
So, ladies and gentlemen, this is Victoria. Say hello, Victoria. Victoria and I met in Stratford about a month ago at a Chamber of Commerce event, and she happens to do a little bit of entertaining now and then, and we kind of got talking about the different projects we do, and I said, well, my next project is going to be the Christmas show at the Front Porch Show, and she said, what's that? And when she heard about it, she said, well, I got to get in on that. Right, so this is her first time performing in St. Mary's in front of a crowd, so she's probably a bit shy, so we're going to take it a little bit easy on her, you know. So maybe, Victoria, maybe I'll start, and then you join in whenever you're comfortable.
You'll have to teach me the song. I don't think I know it very well.
I'm
good at picking stuff up.
It doesn't quite fit tonight, but it's quite Christmas.
We can always dream, right?
Sure. Frank, can you back us up there?
Let's swing it a little bit.
Okay, everybody can have some fun. Victoria, welcome to St. Mary's.
Thank you.
Just like the one I used to know, where the treetops glisten and children listen to hear sleigh bells in the snow.
Come
on! I'll try.
Why don't you guys want to join us? I mean, now that you know the words.
Ready?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3,
go!
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten. Listen to hear
Victoria, I think you're getting a handling on this. Oh, wow.
I have to tighten up my underwear for that one.
Oh. Long underwear do the job. It's like Spanx and flannel all in one.
I'm going to have to think about that next time because I'm a little cold up here. But I think you're really getting it, Victoria. I don't know about you guys, but I think she's gotten over her shyness. I think maybe we could do maybe one more, Frank. What would you like to do, Victoria?
I don't know,
something easy.
Jingle bells? Silent night? Oh, holy night.
I like that one.
Do you know that
one?
All
right, I think we can try that one.
Okay.
You want to sing with me?
Well, why don't you start this time and I'll join in when I think of it.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth.
Hey!
you, that is really front porch show singing, I'll tell you.
Wow, you really taught me how to sing.
One practice, ladies and gentlemen.
Next, we'll do the funny duet.
If that doesn't make you feel like Christmas, I don't know what will. I think Don, that may have doubled our budget, right, for the show?
Will my salary be going up again?
I think so. Okay, we're going to throw it over now to Will and Charlotte. Will and Charlotte, tell us what you're going to do.
I have Charlotte with me. How old are you, Charlotte?
I'm 9 and...
Today.
Happy birthday.
Toad.
I'm 9.
Today!
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
Way to go. Okay. Beautiful.
Keep going.
What's your favorite Christmas song, Charlotte? That's a nice song. How are you liking interviewing people?
It's fun.
Hey, great. Charlotte, would you like to meet Santa Claus right now?
No.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, St. Mary's own Santa Claus, come up here. Come on up here.
There won't be a Christmas show without having at least a little bit of Santa Claus. Okay, you want to
meet
Santa
Claus? Here we go. Watch the ice.
Is our really Santa Claus? Santa Claus, Santa Claus. Is our really Santa Claus? Is our really Santa? He's got a long and white, fluffy beard run down his chest up to his ears. On Christmas Eve, he disappears. Is our really Santa? Go! Is our really Santa Claus? Santa Claus, Santa Claus. Is our really Is Art really Santa?
Dance, go ahead! Santa's here!
He's got a crop of hair that looks like snow. Bifocals halfway down his nose. His tummy droops, overflows.
Is Art really
Santa?
One more!
Is Art really Santa Claus? Santa Claus is our really Santa Claus. Is our really Santa?
Nice hand for Santa Claus, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I got one question to ask you. What do you have in that bag for me?
For you?
Well, I got your toque. Whoa! Okay.
Papi Le Duc.
Okay, thank you very much.
It's little Frankie here.
It's Frankie's back there.
Yes, I am. Santa, do I have a toy?
Give me something, please.
Here we go, little Frankie.
Okay, a little Frankie.
It's got reindeer and Santa. It's a toy for you.
Oh, my dear. Thank you very much, Santa Claus.
What? Frank gets a tie and I get this little dinky thing?
Okay.
And just in case there wasn't a mic, I brought my own.
You brought your own?
Yeah.
He's got a mic. That one
I love you, baby. I love you.
Give me that tie.
I'll trade you your tie for... No.
Anyway, thanks, John.
Happy Christmas, okay?
Merry Christmas,
Merry
John.
Christmas,
Merry Christmas,
yeah.
Santa.
Okay.
Nice hand for Earth, Santa Claus.
As we have mentioned, the Front Porch Show has been gathering letters for our troops, and we're now going to give them all to our next special guest, Nancy Loeffler. Is that how you say your name? Give her the mic, Don. So close enough means what?
It means my husband's from Germany originally, and I can't even pronounce it the way they do. So.
Okay. Any Germans in the audience? We have somebody from Turkey, somebody from France. Okay. So anyways, you're going to tell us, we have the letters, and we've got Charlotte and Will bringing our letters. We've got quite a few. I'd say definitely well over 100. And if you want to do one before the show ends, we've got some extra forms to fill out. But they're going out tonight.
And go on to Nancy and tell us a story of your personal connection.
So 2 years ago, my son decided to join the Canadian Armed Forces. So he's been doing that for 2 years and he loves it. And even when he was in basic training, the Presbyterian Church wrote letters to him, and he said that those letters helped him find the strength to keep going, to get through all the training. And so I really appreciate everyone writing letters to soldiers who can't make it home for Christmas, because again, it will help them push through and keep going.
So where do the letters go from here now?
I'm going to send them to the base in Padawawa where my son is stationed.
Yeah.
And he's going to pass them over to his superiors, and they will send them off to either Afghanistan or anywhere else the soldiers may be.
So Afghanistan, where it's warm, they're going to get warm greetings
yes.
from St. Mary's. Anybody that brought a letter or had a hand in getting a letter, thank you very much. You did a great thing. Hopefully yes. your Christmas is going to be just a bit better.
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, we got some more.
Yep.
Oh, these ones from Fawcett Tractor Supply. Oh, wow, there's quite a few in there. Thank you, Fawcett. Where's the Fawcett? Oh, look at this. This is from the ANAF. So we got even more.
Okay.
And the ones from the flower shop and more in there, plus all the ones that people brought in personally. We got, whoops, there's another one. Holy, that's great. Wonderful.
Thank you
very much, folks. Okay, well, help her put the letters there. And we got some more. Come on on!
Thank you.
I got the boys to work. Okay. Well, we've done that this year. We certainly got well over 100 this year.
Absolutely.
Next year, my goal is to get one for every soldier. That means 2,100. St. Mary's, what do you think? Can we do it?
Yes.
Because we didn't start early enough. Nancy, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you're going to be involved next year. I didn't know about you till about yesterday.
Oh.
So you're going to get involved next year. We're going to push it to the 2100 mark next year. We can do it. Because why? We're St. Mary's. And we can do anything. Okay, thank you, Nancy.
Thank you.
Okay. Now, we're going back. Oh, you're going to interview Will. Okay, Charlotte, go ahead.
So, Will, how old are you?
I'm 11 years old.
What grade are you in?
Grade 6.
What was your favorite part of the show so far?
Frankie on the piano.
Being with the interviewers.
Oh, that's nice. Nice. What's your favorite part of Christmas?
Well, the gifts are great, but I really like doing the Christmas carols and watching Christmas TV shows.
That's nice.
Who's your favorite people on the show?
Who's your favorite people on the show?
Robert Edmund.
Okay, cut, get them off.
John, we have a new host.
They're gone. That's the last you'll see of them. Okay, many of you know Ashley Agar from the Evans Touch the Truck team, but she doesn't just stop there. She's a very giving person in our community. So we got Ashley on. What have we got you on? Oh, we got some high school students as well. Great. Okay, so let's talk about what you're doing, Ashley.
Okay, well, for the 8th year in a row, we, myself and a small group of people, have been collecting donations, and with that money we purchase hand creams and then take them up to the nursing homes and give them out, usually on 23rd or 24th, or this sort of thing. We sometimes have enough to do both Wildwood and Kingsway, sometimes just one, so we kind of bounce back and forth between. But this year we have the DCVI students that are really just taking it to a whole nother level and are doing fundraising amongst themselves, and it's just really, really awesome. So we were hoping to be able to easily do one of the homes this year, but because of the efforts of the DCVI students, we are going to be able to do both the homes in St. Mary's this year and have extras that we're going to be able to give our team to give out in the nursing homes in Stratford as well.
Okay, thank you very much. That's great. Who are these people, though? They're just sort of standing here. I don't know who they are.
I'm Serena Shepherd.
Okay.
And I'm Samantha Shepherd.
And I'm their mom, Kristen. And they're leading the charge.
Okay, I say DCVI students. That's great. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much. Haven't we got great youth in this town? They do a great job. Okay. I'm going to hand this part of my show to my very good friend, Don Van Galen, although he's called Van Galen.
I'm still here, John.
He's still here. Good stuff. And he has a story to tell. Go ahead, Don.
All right, so we're going to do a little bit of song, and this is audience participation. You all know this song. You might not know where it originated from, but there was another Christmas special a couple hundred years ago. And it must have been a By the Seat of Our Pants production, John, because it was in a church in Germany 200 years ago, and on Christmas Eve, when they wanted to play music, they found out that the organ wouldn't work because mice had chewed the bellows and the air couldn't be pushed through the pipes. So they had to come up with a different musical repertoire. So what did they do? Well, they had a guy with a guitar compose a brand new Christmas song. And we're going to do that for you tonight. And it's called Silent Night. And Victoria did such a good job keeping up with me earlier that I thought I'd invite her to help me out with this one, too.
Yes. Don, do we have to pay her more?
She said she would do this as a special add-on, no extra charge.
Okay, good. And she signed her rider. And it's good.
Oh, yeah, I got signatures.
And if people got their light bracelets out there on?
So okay, we want to see you. We want to see your... These don't actually glow very well under the lights.
Yeah, let them all glow.
We want to see yours glowing, and we want to help. So, Victoria, would you like to come out and help me sing?
I sure would. I got the glow stick.
Woohoo! Microphone for you.
So, let it glow, let it glow, let it glow.
Just be that out by now.
Ready? We're going to do it a key that's basically a little lower so everybody can sing along.
Really, though. Silent night.
Is that good?
Silent night. Holy night. All is calm. All is bright.
Heavenly.
Thank you, Santa. Thank you, Victoria. All right. Oh, Frank's got to get the hugs in.
There's a harmonica, Frank.
You got a harmonica there, Frank.
Is that mine?
I do all the time.
You have a harmonica?
I'd like to introduce you to Will's favorite front porch show guy. Where are you, Will? Where is
right
it?
There.
Where are you? Will, I can't see you.
Behind the lights, that's why you can't see him.
Okay, I can't see him. Okay. Will, you've done your last interview, but that's okay.
Will and Charlotte did amazing tonight. Yeah, they're going to come up
and...
Will and Charlotte!
One of these days...
They'll be hosting this show 20 years from now.
Oh, maybe
or
less than that.
Less than that. So...
I won't be around forever, and we want this show when they open up the iPod, the pod, what do you call that thing, the time capsule, we want, 50 years from now, we want the iPod, anyways, 48 years
time
from
capsule.
Now. Yes, we want the front porch show still to be going.
I'll be there.
We've got a Christmas tree here, it's been donated by the Staffins, and we appreciate that. Not everybody has a Christmas tree. If you need a Christmas tree, come and talk to Rob at the end of the show. We will put your name into the hat. There's only one person. It's no problem, is it?
Yeah.
But if you need a Christmas tree, we'll put it and have a draw, and somebody will be walking home with a Christmas tree.
This beautiful Christmas tree from Rob and Sharon Staffin. And yeah. Thank you.
So, okay. How many are here?
Yeah. Sorry, also, I just want to say, we have grab bags, goodie bags for the kids, quite nicely, Ron McDonald from The Independent gave to us, and we also want to give a shout out to the other Independent.
Yes.
The Independent newspaper who ran the article for us, the letter for us.
Yes.
So that everyone could have a copy of that.
You just stole my
Did
line.
I steal it? I'm
yes,
sorry.
That's okay, I don't have to say that now.
John.
Yes.
Got a little message for you.
Oh, holy smokes. That's good.
I want to wish a Merry Christmas to all of our family and friends, and especially to my beautiful mother. Today is her birthday, as well as Charlotte's.
Okay, fantastic. Merry Christmas, mother. Incredible. Unbelievably true. But this show would be much better with a different host. How many are here for the first Christmas special? Put up your hand. How many people are going to be coming back next year? How many people are going to be bringing a friend? Because we want to... it's funny, this show is really unusual. Because the number of people we get coming out on a cold evening in Canada... people in warmer climates must think we're crazy, but we are. We're Canadian. We do this. But not only are Canadian, we're from St. Mary's. And we do this kind of thing. So next year, I want to see if we can get 1,000 people here. That's a goal. 1,000 people and 2,100 letters for our troops. Don't forget, if you got anything to donate to the Salvation Army, it's here. We got the kettle, and we're going to be selling our mugs after the show for $20 a peach.
Peach.
$20 a piece.
$20 and a peach?
And, yes. And $10 of each $20 goes to the Salvation Army. And if you want to put in more than $20, we have a mug here, Don. Where did that mug go? They're beautiful. Yes. They're absolutely beautiful.
I'll grab one.
And they're great stocking stuffers, as everybody says. And it's better than the kitchen magician, which we know is the perfect gift, right?
Of course.
So
I have to tell you, my coffee tastes 20% better. In the morning.
There
and that's
go.
A guarantee. I'll guarantee your coffee tastes better in a front porch mug. $20. $10 goes to... The Salvation Army.
So please buy your mugs. Be generous. You can pay more than $24, $28. You want to give it $100? Great. You'll get a mug. We'll give you two mugs for $100.
And at Starbucks, you get mugs for $90. So it's a deal, right?
It's a great deal. But it's all for the Salvation Army. It's okay? So, guess what? That's it for our Christmas special. How many people are cold now?
Can we do one more song, John?
Do you want to do one more song?
Can we do one more?
What one do you want to do?
Frank?
Oh, yes. First, I got to say thank you.
Oh, you do that.
Frank, stop. Stop. Cut. I got to say thank you first. There's a lot of people...
Well, say it.
You can do it while he's playing.
Say it.
If you want to do the intro, go ahead. Again, we'd like to thank the Staffins and the St. Mary's Golf Country Club for being our sponsor. The True Independence, the newspaper, and the grocery store have been most kind. Wasn't it great being worn by baristas?
Thank you, baristas.
And for the hot chocolate company, let's not forget the Salvation Army for their cooperation. And how about Fawcett Tractor Supply? And we have the flower shop and more. And the St. Mary's ANAF. And all those who helped us gather letters for our troops. And of course, we couldn't do it without the generous donation of the time and the talent of our performers and crew. And we do it all for you. That sounds like a pretty good slogan, right? Okay, so now it's time for Frank to take us home.
I was born in Ontario, a place to stand, a place to grow. From Pickle Lake to Point Pelee, no place I'd rather be than my hometown they call Stone Town. Prettiest town for miles around, where little false laugh people share smiles, treat you like family. You know the song? Here we go. I've been amazed, I've been blessed, and God is great. I was led to this special place. It's quite a mystery, where anyone can be a friend, and farmers' fears they never end. Through it all flows the mighty Thames. What a sight to see.
Saint Mary's home to me. want, Santa. Oh, St. Mary, St. Mary's home. To you and Santa and me and the Front Porch Show and the whole world, we love you. Thanks for coming down for the Christmas special.
Merry Christmas, St. Mary!
Next year.